फ्रेंड्स, माय नेम इज़ डॉक्टर पुरु धवन एंड इन दिस वीडियो वी विल टॉक अबाउट दोज फूड आइटम दैट शुड बी अवॉइडेड इन ए किडनी फेलियर पेशेंट. इन किडनी फेलियर पेशेंट्स इट्स वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टू मेक सर्टेन चेंजेस इन योर लाइफ स्टाइल एंड सर्टेन चेंजेस इन योर डाइट बिकॉज दिस चेंजेस नॉट ओनली हेल्प टू कंट्रोल द लेवल ऑफ क्रिएटिनिन, लेवल ऑफ यूरिया, लेवल ऑफ पोटेशियम इन योर बॉडी, इट ऑल्सो हेल्प्स योर बॉडी, योर किडनी टू परफॉर्म बेटर. एंड सर्टेन बैड चॉइसेस इन आवर डाइट can damage this our kidney or can raise the level of creatinine or they can push us towards the dialysis or transplant. So let's start with number first item, and that is protein. If you are a kidney failure patient and you take lots of red meat, eggs, fish, mutton, chicken, dairy products, your creatinine will increase definitely. In a kidney failure patient, it is advised that if you take low amount of protein or the protein which is easily absorbable by the body, which produces lesser amount of waste material, lesser amount of creatinine, that will help all kidney failure patient for better condition. So at Sai Sanjini, we advise all our kidney failure patients to take protein free diet or protein low protein diet, because you can control the level of creatinine with the help of protein. Creatinine is a base material which is produced by your muscles, and if you take lots of protein, your level of creatinine also increases, which is also reflected in your reports, kidney function reports. So if you want to control the level of creatinine, or do you want to lower down the level of creatinine, you have to avoid protein completely, or you have to go for those protein which are easily absorbable, and you have to take care of the portion size of the protein also. So at Sai Sanjeevi, we advise all kidney failure patients to take either one bowl of moong ki dal, or you can take two egg whites on a daily basis purpose. Only if your level of creatinine is around 3 or 4, if the level of creatinine is above 4, these items should be avoided. Now let's move to the other food items that damages kidney. In a kidney failure patient, the main cause of kidney failure is always comes out to be either BP or your high level of sugar. Now let's move to the item number 2, and that is caffeine. Caffeine is a thing which is we take in form of coffee. If you are a kidney failure patient and you consume coffee, means you are consuming caffeine on a daily basis, what we see that the condition of kidney failure worsen day by day, because caffeine is a thing which elevates your blood pressure, and all kidney failure patient, hypertension is a thing which damages kidney. So if you want to control the higher hypertension, you have to avoid your caffeine. So all kidney failure patient at Sai Sanjeevi advise to totally avoid caffeine, because this thing will help to control your hypertension. Now let's move to the item number 3, and the item number 3 is salt. Salt is very well known for its hypertensive properties, and all kidney failure patients suffers from hypertension. Imagine a kidney failure patient who is suffering from hypertension consume lots of amount of salt. What will happen? This large amount of salt will increase hypertension further, and that can damage the kidney. So at Sai Sanjeevi, we advise all kidney failure patients to take either salt-free diet or one pinch salt diet. This will not only help patient to control the blood pressure, it will also help all kidney failure patients to slow down the progression of this disease. Let's move to the item number 4, and the item number 4 is artificial sweetener. What we see in kidney failure patients, that a large number is composed of those patients which are diabetic, and in a diabetic patient, consumption of artificial sweeteners are very common, but these artificial sweeteners are very hard for kidney to expel it out. They are good for taste, but they are bad for kidneys. So all the patients of Sai Sanjeevi suffering from kidney failure disease are advised to totally avoid all kind of artificial sweetener or any kind of beverages which contains artificial sweetener like aspartate or saccharine, because they are not safe for the kidney. That damages your kidney and increases the progression of kidney failure disease. Now let's move to the other item. Next item which has to be avoided by all kidney failure patients is dairy products. Any kind of milk or any kind of milk product are to be avoided by kidney failure patient, because these dairy products are rich in protein, calcium and phosphates, and these things are to be controlled in a kidney failure patient. So at Science and Jeevani, we advise not to take any kind of dairy products. This will not only help you to control the level of creatinine, but this will also help you to control the level of calcium and phosphate in your body. Next item on our list is NSAID and antibiotics. These two kind of medicine, which are usually known as painkillers and antibiotics, are very harmful for the kidney. And if a kidney failure patient take these kind of medicine, either by doctor's prescription or by self-medication, these two medicine can harm a kidney failure patient in a very bad way. So at Science and Jeevani, we advise all kidney failure patients to avoid these medicines. Take these medicine only when they are very, very necessary. Now let's move to our next item, and the next item is alcohol. Alcohol is a thing which has to be filtered out by your kidney, and if your kidney is performing low, this alcohol intake can damage your kidney. So at Science and Jeevani, we advise all kidney failure patients to avoid any kind of alcohol intake. Next item is high potassium food and vegetables. In a kidney failure patient, the level of potassium has to be maintained, because potassium is a very dangerous thing in a kidney failure patient, and if the level of potassium reaches above 7, it may cause heart attack. So to control the level of potassium, it's very important for all kidney failure patient to understand high potassium fruits and vegetables. In this video, I will try my level best to make you understand about the high potassium fruits and vegetables. So let's start with fruits first. In fruits, you have to avoid banana, kiwi, avocado, dry fruits, dates, coconut, because these all fruits are high in potassium. And other fruits which are not described here are considered as low in potassium, but the portion size is very important. If you're taking any kind of fruit like apple, guava, chiku, muskmelon, watermelon, quantity is very important. So if you are a kidney failure patient, you have to take just 1 cup of fruit. You can take 1 cup of muskmelon, you can take 1 cup of watermelon, you can take 1 cup of papaya, chiku, but quantity size will remain the same. You can fill this cup with mix of fruits, but the portion size will remain the same. Now let's move to the vegetables. High potassium vegetables are very dangerous. In vegetables, you have to avoid all kind of rooty and leafy vegetables. Rooty vegetables like potato, sweet potato, turnip, beetroot, which is grown below the surface of earth, has to be avoided. And all leafy vegetables like coriander, parsley, spinach has to be avoided. And all vegetables which are grown as a fruit on a plant or caper can be given to a kidney failure patient. They are considered as low in potassium, like brinjal, ladyfinger, bittergourd, snakegourd, round gourd, pumpkin. These vegetables are low in potassium, but we have to leach these vegetables before cooking so that these vegetables become much more safer for a kidney failure patient to use. These are the main food items which has to be avoided by all kidney failure patients, so that the level of creatinine, so the level of urea and potassium can be maintained. So if you have any kind of doubt, you have any kind of inquiry, you can call on the number given below. Our doctors will help you. You can also book an appointment with me on the number given below. You can also visit our website sainkidneycare.com, where we have given a very small form in which you have to give us the details like your name, age, gender, what kind of kidney failure you are suffering from, your level of creatinine, either you're going for dialysis or not. You have to fill that form and send to our doctors. When our doctor examine that, they can make what kind of kidney failure you are suffering from, what are the causes of behind your kidney failure, and accordingly your kidney function restoration treatment can be started. With this, I think it's time to say goodbye. See you in our next video. Goodbye.